My sense is because policy does not look into the nitty-gritties of what it says while it makes policy is the fundamental problem to me, right? And this, to me, has been very well structured in some of the policy-making processes. And if we were to follow them very closely and critically, we will not have. I always say, why did we not brand our condoms well in 50s? Right? I always have this question to myself. When I was born, why was at that time condom not used by my father, right? My sense is that we did not brand it the way we should brand our public health products. The branding, we need to learn from corporate a lot for this and bring it into our policy construct. As Sir said, there's a lack of public trust in public system. And I think this is again to do with a poor branding of public health systems and public health policies, right? We have never been able to take our public health and public health policy to the last mile that we are talking about. We have always taken a worker who is most disinterested in reaching that last mile. To me, public health policy has three major components, right? You know, the first and foremost component it is that we need to decide whom are we making this policy for. It is meant for which construct of population that we are trying to cover. Are we covering everybody in public policy, which for a country like India is a huge challenge? Or are we focusing policy on certain elements or subsets of the country which needs to be addressed through this public policy? And the other subset is only in form of guiding principles, and policies need to be, not that we don't have to take care of every citizen of the country, but again, policies must have prioritizations, right? And those prioritization is something which we lack, and hence, in the end of the day, a delivery to that priority sector of the country is extremely poor. Second thing that comes to my mind while I take this is, what was the process followed? Sir shared certain processes of developing the policy. At present, I'm working with UP state government to drive their national health policy to be made into the UP state health policy. The first and foremost question I asked the health minister and the bureaucracy is, if you want us to drive your policy, are we ready to state down the processes that we want to follow before we take it? Yes, it's great to put this on website, I'm with you, sir, but on the other side, was consultation happening beyond the state functionaries with the communities? The point that I'm saying is, processes don't have to be in the closed rooms, and they need to be done beyond the state power corridors with the clients and the subset of population which we are going to be, because 5,000 inputs, how many of them we need to analyze came for the end client? Where was the end client involved at the level of policy formulation? And to me, that's one of the biggest failures of our policies, that they are done by people like Sunil Mehra's and Sanjeev Kumar's, right? They need to be done beyond Sunil Mehra and Sanjeev Kumar's to people who are right grounded on the community level to get their feel that what is that they want from a sub-center? What is that they want from a frontline worker? We need to modulate that and work backwards. We so often talk about down-up approach, but very often we tend to land up just doing a mini down-up, right? We go up to state, we go up to it's one or two or few districts and get an idea. Get to the client, get to the communities. Sir very clearly laid out the elements of it. Now, elements come out of evidence. I fully buy that process. That elements need to be determined by the epidemiology and the demographic link between epidemiology and the demography of a state. India is too huge, right? It's too huge to have. I normally feel one national health policy in this country is not the only thing we need. Yes, we need a one national health policy, but it needs to be reconstructed or need to be reinforced, as we do for every guideline. Why don't we do for health policy also? That you have a ART guideline, or for child health guidelines, you go to the states. States like to redefine certain elements of it and want to add few. You know, you have core guiding principles, but beyond core guiding principles, what state can bring in is brought in every aspect of it. But same way, health policy needs to be reviewed by states, and state need to add the components that they want to add. Third, which I think is the critical process, is does health policy put itself on targets and outcomes? To say that does policy, and who's, and sir use the word accountability. Policy has to be accountable for what it says and what it does not deliver, or what it does deliver. But convergence is a far-fetched idea. I would really like one of you or two of you or a few of you to do some research on why convergence does not work in this country. How can we still live in 2017 and have child marriage, right? So fundamental issues like child marriage needs to be kind of abolished from the country. Policies are confused with laws and legislation. We need to see that policy is not law. Policy is not a legislation. Out of policy, you can work towards laws and legislation, and not the other way around. But the other way around, you need to keep your policy are in line with the laws and legislation that exist in the country. Village Health and Sanitation Committee was such a powerful tool in the National Health Mission if used well and well constructed in the policy earlier. And we didn't have the enough strengthening of the Village Health and Sanitation Committees to generate the policy environment where VHC could tell us what actually needs to come into policy, what actually needs to be brought upward from the community perceptions. I would end it there. Thank you.